Welcome back to the factory floor. It's time to finish up our work and complete the last task on our to-do list, adding the second robot. In the last video, we prepared the pedestal for the robot by creating a simple column. In this video, we'll finally be adding the second robot to the factory, which will be a Universal Robot UR5, or at least a model of it. And instead of creating this robot ourselves out of the simple geometry we used in the previous videos, we'll be reusing a detailed model created by the Roche community. This will save us a lot of work, and is one of the main advantages of using a framework such as ROS. By reusing existing components, in this case a model of a robot, we can immediately start doing our own work instead of having to spend time modeling the robot ourselves. We have to make a number of changes to the factory to get the robot in place on the pedestal. First, we have to tell ROS to retrieve the definition of the UR5 model. We'll have to point it to the correct package and the correct file within that package to get access to the Zacro we need. Next, the robot model must be instantiated. Importing the definition does not yet add an instance of the model to the scene, so we have to do that explicitly by adding a macro invocation statement. With the robot instantiated, we need to attach it to the world with a joint. With this joint, we'll fixate the robot to the pedestal we created earlier. And finally, we'll have to make sure the robot has the correct orientation, which we'll do by rotating it an appropriate number of degrees. So let's start by opening up our text editor again and loading the hrwros.zacro file. Scroll down to the bottom of the file and make a little room. This is where we'll add the Zacro import statement. It consists of a few parts. First, we add the statement itself, like so. An include statement requires a single argument, namely the file it should include. That should go in the include attribute here. In order to avoid typing in any paths that are only valid on my own computer, I'm going to use something called a package relative path. In short, this means that I'll provide ROS with a package name, and ROS will automatically find it for me and return the path to where that package is located on my hard disk. This makes URDFs very flexible, as they will work no matter where packages are stored. So in this case, we'll ask ROS to look for the UR description package, as that contains the Zacro file that contains the model definition. All we need to do now is tell ROS which particular file it should include from the UR description package. That would be UR5.urdf.zacro in this case. Let's add that here. It's in the URDF subdirectory of the package. Done. With the macro now available, we'll need to call it. Remember, this is just like calling a regular function, say as in C++ or Python, so we'll need to provide all the arguments that the macro expects. Calling a Zacro macro makes ROS insert whatever the contents of the macro is at that specific spot in the URDF. For our factory, this means that we'll add the model definition of the UR5 right after we've included the file that defines it. In real systems, it is nicer if you put all include statements close to each other at the top of the file, as you would in a C++ program. That way, they are not all spread around. So let's add the call. The name of the macro is UR5_robot, so that's what I'll use here. And it expects an argument called prefix. This prefix is put in front of all link and joint names, which allows us to avoid collisions between multiple instances of the same robot model by making sure all links and joints have unique names. As we already have a robot in the factory, we'll give this second robot the prefix robot2_, like so. Now we have added the second robot to the factory scene, but it isn't placed anywhere yet. Just as with the pedestal, we'll have to create a joint that fixates the robot on top of it. We connected the pedestal to the factory via the world link. We won't connect the robot to the factory directly, but we'll use the pedestal link itself. This makes sense. If we ever move the pedestal, the robot will move with it, and we won't have to update the robot's location manually every time. So let's add that joint. We'll first add the required structure. Then we fill in the values for the parent and the child. Remember, we set the prefix argument for the UR5 robot macro to robot2 underscore earlier. So we have to use that here again when specifying the name of the child link, or else it won't work. Now all that's left is putting the robot at the right height. Remember that the pedestal we created consists of a single link, which is located at its bottom, and the pedestal is 60 centimeters tall. So in order for the robot to appear at the right height, we have to specify a distance of 60 centimeters between the base of the robot and the bottom of the pedestal. We do that here again by adding an origin to specify the relative transform and set a value of 0.6 in the entry for the z-coordinate. We're almost done, but the robot does not have the right orientation yet, so it won't face the right part of the factory. To rotate it, we'll add an RPY attribute to the origin element and set the last value to 90 degrees. Remember that ROS uses radians everywhere for rotations, so in order to be able to specify 90 degrees, we'll have to use a trick. Luckily, there is a convenience conversion function that we can use, called radians. This takes in a number of degrees and returns the equivalent rotation in radians. So let's add that here. So now we're all done. Notice the dollar sign and the two curly brackets. Those tell ROS that it should not take this as a literal value, but as a function call. So now let's inspect our result. Make sure to save the Zagro file first. Then we switch to the terminal. And finally, we launch the visualization launch file. The robot's pose is a bit strange like this, all stretched out, but that will be all right as soon as we start controlling it in week 4. But overall, it looks okay. Looks like we have everything in place now and properly positioned as well. So there we are. We've added the second robot. The factory is now almost complete with the two robots, the bin and the conveyor. The only thing missing is a mobile robot to take the parts from robot 1 to robot 2. We'll not add that robot now, as you'll learn about mobile robot navigation in the next module. So for now, this concludes our introduction to world modeling with URDF and Zagro, and with that, week 2 of this course.